Hello for Tuesday, January 11th. That's 1-1-1-1. You know, we've got ISP problems, so we're having to record this outside. So we're limited capability, but still we're doing it anyway. So we've got the Dow 60-minute chart, and you can see it broke the trend line. What happened? Normally when you break a trend line, you'll rally back up into it. And what happens then? That's where a lot of people short. That's exactly what happened. It broke down through 60-minute chart, so we had it a couple hours later, moved right back up into it, and what did people do? They short it, and that was the biggest drop of the day, down to 11,573. Look left, you can see that it's right here in this range of support. 11,530 would be a low, but it didn't get that far, so it got here already and moved right back up to these moving averages. It still looks weak. It's broken now, so unless it starts moving back up in this range, it's just going to be some short-term trades. Do you think eventually if this can, I mean, it looks like when you break a trend that you should come down a little further, and you can look, the 38% over here is at a support area, so is the 50% at a support area, so the valid placement of Fibonacci, so those are possibilities to look forward to as time goes on, and then we'll probably rally up, maybe come to the high later on, but let's see if we can pull back for a few days or a while, maybe a little longer. Okay, we've got SPX, also 60-minute, virtually the same kind of thing, didn't come down as visually quite as far. You can see over here left support below the lower Bollinger Bands, and the 1237 is the first area of, from this high at least, the first area of support at 38.2% at 1237, and on the Russell, we don't think that's a good trade at the moment. It was fine with like this kind of little double bottom, $1 below the last time. It was under the Bollinger Band again, so if you're trading, watch for when they go below the Bollinger Band on a 60-minute. A lot of times it does set up over here it happened, so many times when it happens, when you've got a situation with the Bollinger Band, particularly going sideways, if it drops below, sometimes you can buy it for a quick move up on that. Okay, let's look at anything else in here interesting. Not really. And on the others as well, the RSI isn't below 30 yet. If that does go down that way, then that would be a possibility as a trade. The USD, US dollar, did pull back. It ran up earlier, and then you can see it opened up, it gapped up kind of here, and then it sold off and closed down here. So maybe it's starting off a little more of a consolidation, but it's probably still in an uptrend. It's getting close to a possible breakout here, but it has to consolidate for a while. But they're not bad chances to say that it's going to continue, Euro is going to continue to be weaker. Even though the market pulled back a little bit and looks weaker, we had a lot of good breakouts during the day. JSDA, Jones Soda, 17%. You can see it surpassed a couple of the possible buy points here, and then the top one here. Nice mover, and look at this volume up to 4 million shares. Its normal volume is underneath 1 million, 4 million. That was a nice pick, wasn't it? How about PSSI? Didn't move quite as much, only up about 1%, but did hit the trigger point and got a little bit over the previous high from Friday. SONS also was a pretty good move, up 5.67%. The first trigger here and the second trigger there as well. It's into the gap now, so use caution once it gets in there and above the top Bollinger Band. Sometimes it'll fill and then back down as people that got trapped maybe think they'll get their money back and went up. UNP, Union Pacific, also had a pretty good move for, you know, once you have larger price stocks, sometimes percentage isn't as much of a move, but it was pretty nice. It broke out of range, and that one worked out well also. And ZIOP, also, it didn't end up very much, but it moved up at the time, not bad, and the volume was okay. Not as good as on Friday when it really had big volume, but still above average volume. So this one you may want to watch if you don't own it. Now, if you own it, put a stop down in this area, I suppose, and otherwise watch it, and it could be, you know, if it pulls back a little bit and then the volume dries up, it may be moving, depending on what the market does at the time. Okay, we've got another one to mention, then we'll have put additions to the watch list. SNCR, as you can see here, moved up also and closed up about 2.83%. And CERS also was a move. So we had several, as it turns out, even with a weekday, that did pretty well. Okay, additions to the watch list. Oh, whoops, I'm still on that one. Okay, let's get this one. ASTM, biotech. And, is this on the list that I'm goofy? Down here, it may be. I should check that. I've got really limited access at the moment. But watch this now. If we do have it on the list, and I think maybe we do because we do have biotech. Anyway, 339 is the top side. Remember, though, it's already above the top Bollinger Band. So, and the band's moving up, so if this goes sideways, the band will turn up a little bit more. But anyway, watch that 339 because we like this long black candle over here. And sometimes, as you know, that doesn't cause as much resistance as you would think. It's better if it were back a month or two ago. But still, things could change. It may move up, and the other indicators are moving up as well. PWER over 1137 is what its high was today, and 1136 was over here. Volume, let's take a look. About average, but a little bit above last week just by hair. So PWER is on the list also, as is CEVA. This is a continuation over the high of the day, which is 2428. It's hard to say what that means. It depends on how it opens. If it gaps up, then you have to use a 15-minute rule, as we have a link to it on the homepage. Otherwise, it means that if it pulls back, then it looks like it. Good chances that it will continue later on, and so to watch that, but we can't give a clear point. You look at the volume and show that it wasn't great. It was just a tad bit above average, but it was, so we would look like some higher volume, and probably if it does continue, there will be some bigger volume coming in. EQIX has a couple levels. You can see this 86.20 was the recent high, but also note up here 86.96. Is a 200-day, so that might be some resistance as well, but somewhere between those two, or what I mean, you could trade either one, the 86 or the 87 level, depends on volume, and note that RSI still has room to run. We do have the Williams indicators already up here, but look, the last time, once it got up above, that was positive, and it stayed for a long time. DLX, also a continuation. Its high of the day was 24.32, but one to watch because it did have a nice clean breakout there, had increased volume, not so fantastic as before, but sometimes these, when you have huge volume in the past, that just shows you that it's likely that it may try it again. And of course, as you see, it not only tried it, it surpassed it and did well, but maybe there's room to run. It does as far as the Bollinger Bands go there. And also, we have SKS, and this one over this 1153 is the first level here. And then above that, we have the 1222. So that's not 1123. That is 11, I can't read it. It's on this screen. I'm sorry, I just can't. But I wrote it down and on the watch list, so check it there. But over this first level, 1192, its high of the day was 1195. So this one is, this sure does look like 11 there, but it's not because we're not up there. But this first level and then 1222 is a high. So anyway, that's what we have. So I hope this is all understandable and clear. And that you have a good trading day, but we did have a lot of them today that moved, so hopefully you had some of those and did pretty well. So have a good trading day today, and we'll try and be back if we can again tomorrow with some new ideas. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.